Anin Kinawea. How's it going, everybody? For those of you that are tuning in so far, welcome to another Music Monday with me, Jordan Mowat, Indigenous Support Worker. I hope you're all doing well out there. It seems like a beautiful day from my neck of the woods, anyway. Other than that, along with that, let's get started. And I'm just gonna open up with one of my own songs. Because as a musician, I do write my own music. Or I try to. So this song right here is the most recent one that I've written. Hold on, I just gotta... It says that I'm live, and I hope that's true. Just responding to a message here. And I saw that there was a viewer. And then, I don't know. Yeah, there we go. Awesome. So anyway, I started writing this song, and one question I get asked a song, how do I write music? So when I first started writing music, I had no idea what I was doing. I didn't really know how to write a song. So for a long while, I was just writing a bunch of random stuff. Like a lot of random stuff. Things that kind of just came to my mind, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna write that. I'm gonna write that down. And so after I'd be done writing that song, it wouldn't make any sense as I would start singing. I'd be like, what the heck is this even, you know, talking about, really? And then when I started getting more serious about music, and especially, about songwriting itself. That's when I started listening to, really started listening to music in a sense of trying to understand songs. You know, what is this individual talking about? Or what is this song about? So that's when I started kind of diving into my own emotions and, you know, things that may have happened in the past. And, you know, a lot of songs that you hear on the radio, they're telling stories. It's a story within that song. Sometimes it's somebody who's trying to understand and, get a better understanding of someone else's emotions. Anin Dominic, my friend. So, as I started writing, that's what I tried to do more often, you know, try to understand other people's point of views, maybe what they're going through. So when I, for this song in particular, when I started writing about it, or when I started writing the song, I just kind of started with the chords. And it's just a simple G and an E minor. But keep in mind, I tuned my guitar down to a D, so I'm in D standard right now. And it's funny because usually I'm always playing in E standard. So to tune down lower, it was kind of giving me more inspiration to write other music, other songs. So sometimes if you're stuck, for other musicians out there or aspiring musicians, writing a song, you know, you might hit sometimes you just got to fiddle around with what key your guitar is tuned in. So that's what I did, and you know, I've been able to write a couple more songs since that. But this song here, sometimes I'll just start playing, and I'll hit, I'll go on voice notes or a voice recorder on my phone, and I'll just press record, and I'll just go with the flow. So I might freestyle for a little bit, but then I'll listen to what I recorded, and I'll feed off of that, pick the things that I liked out from there. And the first verse that I got from this, I really liked how it sounded, and I fed off of that. And so after I was done writing this song, I realized that the inspiration that I got from was my grandparents' marriage. So I lost my papa Ray to dementia, Alzheimer's, and dementia and Alzheimer's or whatever. And I got to the point where he couldn't remember who I was. We'd go to their house, you know, Natalie and I, and to pay them a visit. And my Nana would have to say to my papa, you know, like, Ray, you know, it's Jordan. Remember Jordan, your grandson? And he kind of just stare at me, and he'd be like, oh, okay, yeah. And sometimes he would have a hard time remembering who my Nana was. And so we lost him to that. But after I was done finished writing this song, I realized that this kind of had something to do with it.
Never thought this was how we would end. I guess I just never ever thought of it. And now we're both left with things unsaid. I guess we just never ever thought of this. But how long can we stay apart this time around? I never thought I'd ever introduce myself. The very first time I ever saw you around, it took me a while to tell you how I felt. One of the last times I saw you around, I felt weak in my knees. They trembled uncontrollably, and breaking down. I really didn't mean to break yours.
So that's the start over. That's what I called that one. And I wrote that on a late night, one night, just out of inspiration. And sometimes I just get these shots of, whew, time to write a song, thankfully. So, so I have a little bit of a background of, you know, kind of understanding music, especially on, I guess, educational point of view or a classical point of view. I took vocal class in high school for a few years, and that really helped develop my voice. Powwow and round dance singing also helped, you know, with developing my voice. And the thing about round dance songs or powwow songs and how we sing, sometimes you can take a classical aspect or a musical aspect from that, and you can kind of point out some of the things that you'll hear in our songs. And for me, I can point some of these things out. And I'm just going to share a quick song. And I just want you to listen to the melody of the song. Especially if there's any music teachers that are watching right now. Just listen to the song and you might be able to understand what I mean by, you know, talking about musical language. You know, you might hear a little bit of an augmented vocal range or a diminished vocal range. You might hear, you know, a sharp in there, or you might, you know, you might hear a flat somewhere of a note. And sometimes you can even hear when we sing, we'll sing in a crescendo part, and we might sing a deep crescendo part. So this song, you'll kind of hear a difference in changes, but it's amazing, and it fascinates me as a singer who sings this style. Even I get fascinated by some of these songs. And I'm just gonna sing it real quick. Pitch change in there. So I'll do it again and just listen to it. I'll give you to where it fascinates me. Song composers or power song composers, they might not think anything like that. You know, they might not have like, oh yeah, this sounds, I don't know what pitch I'm hitting or whatever, but you know, they might not think how we think when we hear that, or how I think when I hear that. But you know, they might just have the thought, okay, yeah, that sounds pretty cool, or that sounds nice, I'm gonna stick with that. But for me, I think that's something that just sounds completely genius. Because it's not written. So these songs, they're not written. You can't really take, well, you might be able to take the song as a musical teacher, and you might be able to write it down on a piece of paper, you know, the notes and whatnot. But for myself, I could not be able to transcript that. I wouldn't be able to do that. I wouldn't be able to put the accents. But if you think about it in that sense, we do have accents when we sing those songs. And, you know, a lot of people ask, what are you saying? So in that song in particular, I'm not saying anything. I'm just singing a melody. That's what it is. But there are songs where you'll hear me singing in the language where I am saying something, and that'll, you know, translate to English. Or I might just use English words. So this is one of my own compositions here. And you're going to hear that little different change in pitch. And you're going to hear the English words in here. Another question I'll get asked is, you know, how do you come up with a round dance song, and where do you get the lyrics? How do you come up with the lyrics? So when it comes to round dance, a lot of the songs, or a lot of the type of style of songs you'll hear is songs to do with romance, you know, heartbreak, sad songs. You'll have funny songs out there, but a lot of these types of songs revolve around having a sweetheart. So in the language, we'll say nabuzgim, or in Cree, they'll say nichimus. And that's our sweetheart. So when people dance at a round dance, a lot of the times we're holding hands, and, you know, dance, somebody might go into the round dance by themselves and be coming out of the round dance with a new girlfriend or boyfriend sometimes. But we have these songs called two-step songs as well. And those two-step songs are just like round dance songs. They're all social songs, and not all the time the lyrics, they don't have to rhyme. You know, it's kind of just like you know, when you think of haiku, a haiku poem doesn't rhyme, but it tells a story. You know, it'll focus on one event or one thing. So some of the songs that I make, they don't always rhyme. But the feeling is there, if you understand what I mean by that. So this is an example of a two-step song.
Hey, 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 tippy. We will watch the sun rise in the morning high. We are high, we are high.
So that's an example of a two-step song. So two-step songs will always happen at a powwow. Sometimes they always do. Majority of the time they will. And everyone is more than welcome to participate. It's a lot different from a round dance, though. So you'll have two people who will lead that dance, and usually it'll be the head male and the head female dancers. And, you know, for the people that spectate, they're in for a very wonderful treat. So it's kind of just like Simon Says, or you gotta copy those people. So it's usually, you know, someone will go up with their partner, or sometimes the MC will be like, we have a two-step song coming up, ladies' choice, all you beautiful women out there, go up and find a man who might be sitting alone and bring him on out on the dance floor for this two-step. So usually an MC will do that, and that's when a lot of the men will be like, oh God, I can't, I'm not ready for this. Or they'll get really shy. Majority of the time, you know, that woman will just go and choose her husband, or, you know, or choose her girl. Then we dance, and, you know, you'll see those dancers, you know, they might represent two eagles flying together in the sky, and they'll be going, swinging and swaying together, or they might show two people paddling a canoe. There's a whole bunch of other things out there that they'll do, and it's just it's a beautiful, beautiful thing, and everyone's always laughing and having a good time. Okay. So everyone's enjoying themselves so far. You're all comfortable. Everyone's having a good time. So me and my band, we just released a song yesterday on all streaming platforms. So if you have Spotify, if you have iTunes, I just totally forgot my password. If you have Spotify, iTunes, or any other type of streaming service that you use, look up the name My Friend the Moon. You'll come across me, and we just released a song called Runaway. So that came out yesterday. So if you have any free time today, would really be awesome if you took the time to listen to that song. So thank you. That would be great. That would be great, lad. Okay. So I got time for, I think, one more song. And I'm going to go back in time with this one. And, or maybe I'll do two more, we'll see. But this song is, by one of the greatest bands of all time. And especially one of the greatest songwriters of all time. And this is one song that inspired me to actually, you know, really write music. So, My Friend the Moon is the name of the band, yeah. Alright, here we go.
Words are flowing out like endless rain into a paper cup. They slither while they pass, they slip away across the universe. Pools of sorrow, waves of joy are drifting through my open mind, possessing and caressing me. Jaguar, Deva, light, which dance before me like a million eyes. They call me on and on across the universe. Thoughts meander like a restless wind inside a letterbox. They tumble blindly as they make their way across the universe. Of life are ringing through my open ears, inciting in me. Limitless, undying love, which shines around me like a million suns and calls me on and on across the universe.
My voice cracked very badly just back there, and my dad being a musician himself, he always said, if you ever mess up or if your voice goes out, don't ever stop playing that song. Don't ever stop playing a song. Don't ever stop. I was like, all right. And my dad, a hard guy, and even to this day, if you ever comes to watch me play, or if you ever did, I'd still get nervous. And he's been in the business for a long time, and oh yeah, he would always, even if I did stop playing that song, and if I looked out in the crowd, I'd see him shaking his head at me, and I'd be like, ah, yeah, it'd be kind of an awkward moment. You know what? I'm gonna do one more song, just because I'm having such a good time. So, the whole pandemic thing and isolation and quarantine thing is starting to get to me a little bit. Starting to wear me down. Not mentally, just kind of, I don't know, it's weird. I'm having a hard time wrapping my head around it. And it's just weird. It's so weird that this is happening right now in the world, you know? And, you know, it sucks because, you know, I'm not able to just get in my car or in my truck and just drive to Oliverville and visit with my mom and dad. I mean, I can, but it's just, I, we're just so scared about taking that risk, you know? With this virus, you know, it says it's an incubation thing of 10 days. You don't know that you have it until 10 days later. And so I'll be thinking like, okay, maybe we'll go see my mom and dad this weekend. And then I'll get thinking, oh, I should wait 10 days though. And then the next weekend will come, I'll be like, okay, I should wait another 10 days. And it's just,
yeah.
But, you know, we're hanging in there, keeping busy, and we're having a good time. So I'm going to end with this song. And even though my my grandmother doesn't have Facebook, I'm going to send this song out to her anyway. And I might have already shared it with you guys. Maybe not. But this was her wedding song with my Papa Ray. So she was married to my Papa Mowat. And that's my... But then, you know, they later divorced and whatnot. And then she remarried to my Papa Ray. And this was their wedding song. And I remember my dad, he said, you should learn this song and play it for Nana. She would be completely blown away. And at first I was like, I'm not really into that, you know, that's not really my style. And I just don't really want to. I was like, I mean, I like the guy, he's got great music. I was like, but I don't know. And then all of a sudden I started learning the song. And then for my Aunt Vicky's retirement party, my mom and dad threw, they asked me to play some music. And I was like, okay, cool. And then my dad was like, you're going to play the song, right? I was like, okay, yeah, I will. So I'll end this one here. And send this one out to my Nana. If you're with your spouse, grab them by the hand. And even though it's daytime right now, we're gonna play a little bit of Harvest Moon. Come a little bit closer, hear what I have to say. Just like children sleeping, we could dream this night away. Because there's a full moon rising, let's go dancing in the light. We know when the music's playing, let's go out and feel the night. Because I'm still in love with you, I wanna see you dance again. Because I'm still in love with you on this harvest moon. When we were strangers, I watched you.
from afar. When we were lovers, I loved you with all my heart. But now it's getting late, and the moon is climbing high. I want to celebrate seeing shining in your eyes. Because I'm still in love with you, I want to see you dance again. Because I'm still in love with you, because I'm still in love with you, I wanna see you again. Because I'm still in love with you on this harvest moon.
All right. Thank you very much for tuning in, folks. Really appreciate it. So with that being said, I hope you all are doing wonderful and that you're all safe and sound. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep yourself busy. We have a lot of time to, be able to discover new things about ourselves. I'm not sure if I mentioned this, but I discovered that I enjoy cooking. And I'm a do the dishes while dinner is cooking type of guy. Most people might think, why don't you just do the dishes anyway? I don't know. I'd rather do them while I'm cooking dinner. It kind of makes the process of food cooking go by faster, if you know what I'm saying. If you want to pick up a new hobby, order yourself a guitar. Learn a few songs on the guitar. Start to sing, maybe you can learn another language. I don't know. Other things that can keep ourselves busy and add to our portfolio in a sense. My brother Joel just uploaded a video regarding cedar, and that was an awesome video. If you haven't seen it, go and check it out. It's right here on our page, Indigenous Education. And, stay tuned for Robin. She does Wellness Wednesday every Friday. No, I'm kidding. Wellness Wednesday every Wednesday with Robin. Monday with me. And, so we're going to be on here frequently. Like I said, make sure you stay tuned. And even if you missed the video, these get reposted anyway. So you can always go back and whatnot. But, so thank you guys for tuning in. I hope you're all having a wonderful day, and like I always say, keep it real like a happy meal, and I'll see you again very soon. So, miigwech, bama pi.